Hello, I am Ignacio, and in this video, I am going to introduce some of the networking products that we can use to make our app services environments better. Okay, so I will be focusing specifically in three products, which are Traffic Manager, Application Gateway, and Azure Frontdoor. So you might be wondering, why would I use these networking products to improve our environments of app services, right? So let me point out some areas that we can help you with. One area definitely will be high availability. Either Frontdoor or Application Gateway or Traffic Manager can help you with this. For instance, if we take Traffic Manager as an example, Traffic Manager can help you setting up two different sites, one in one region and another in another region, and directing, like forwarding all the traffic to one of the regions. And if this region needs some maintenance or there's some sort of outage, then you can fail over and send the traffic to the other region in a transparent manner for the users. So other area that we can help you with is definitely security. Like Application Gateway and Azure Frontdoor can help you with it, with this area by implementing a web application firewall. Like all the requests will be coming to the web application firewall before they actually hit the app service. Also, these two specific products as well, they have very good advanced routing features, like they will help you with URL rewrites, path-based routing, and others, okay? Providing some flexibility on how you handle the requests. Finally, and this only applies to Azure Frontdoor, okay? You can implement some caching. So, due to every product is different, let me go product by product and let's cover Traffic Manager first. Traffic Manager is a load balancer solution based on DNS. It is commonly used to provide high availability environments as I described before in an active passive scenario, but it's not the only routing method that you can use. Here in this slide, you can see that there's multiple, like priority, which will be the active side and passive side, weighted, like giving more weight to one side to another, but not excluding the other side. Performance, like based on the closest endpoint to the client. Geographic, multi-value, and subnet. So as you see, there's several options and they can adapt to different scenarios. Let's have a look at the demo of Traffic Manager. So for this demo, we are gonna have a Traffic Manager profile and two app services. One in region A, which is North Europe, and another in region B, which is West Europe. So we will configure a scenario of active-passive, having North Europe or region A as active. To do this, we go to configuration and we set up priority method, okay? Once we do that, we can go to the endpoints and assign the priority that we want. As you can see on this screen, region A has priority 1, meaning that it is the active side, whereas region B has this priority 2 being the passive side. So if we go directly to the website of region A, we see region A. If we go directly to the website of region B, we see region B. But if we go to Traffic Manager, it is actually serving the request to region A. So let's stop region A app service and see how Traffic Manager failovers to region B. Okay, we get into the app service and then we click in stop. So we click on stop, we confirm, and then we check if we retrieve a 403 error, stopped. Okay, so the application is stopped. Now let's check the status in Traffic Manager. Traffic Manager should have already detected that the app service is stopped. So as we can see in the monitor status, region A is stopped. So after waiting for a while, we confirm that the app service is still stopped, the region A app service, and that the Traffic Manager URL is pointing right to region B, which is what we expected. So this confirms the scenario of active passive. So let's talk about Application Gateway. Basically, Application Gateway is a layer 7 load balancer that provides you some advanced routing features. For example, URL rewrites and URL redirections. Also, a very common feature is path-based routing, which allows you to route one specific path, for instance, as an example. Let's say we have documents in the path slash media, and you redirect all the requests to one backend, whereas the rest of the requests go to a different one. It is important to take into account that Application Gateway is a regional service, meaning that your endpoint, your public IP, is located in a specific region. Be aware as well that you can use a private IP for Application Gateway. As well, it can provide some additional features by using a web application firewall, and also provide some SSL offload capabilities, releasing your backend from that duty. So for the Application Gateway demo, we're going to have two sites and we are going to do path-based routing between both for the path slash contact. So let me show first the main configuration of the Application Gateway itself. First of all, the first configuration item that we have is the frontend IP, which is basically an IP which is regionally based in North Europe in my case. Therefore, it is very important to highlight again that it's regional. Then we have two backend pools, okay, one with the app in region A and the other with the app in region B. If we go to the rules, which is the brain of the Application Gateway, we can see how we correlate the IP with the backend. So if we click on the HTTPS rule that we have here, we have what we call a listener, which is a combination of IP and port that we are listening into. And then we have the backend targets, where we are routing all the traffic to App Service 1, which is in region A, and the page will show region A, and the HTTP settings, which are the settings that we use to talk to our backend. If we check at the very bottom, we have a path-based rule for the path slash contact, which will be redirected to the App Service 2, which is the backend in region B. So let's have a look at how the pages look like. For region A contact, we have region A contact, and the home as well shows region A. For region B, we have in the contact page, we have region B contact. So if we go to Application Gateway, based on our setup, the main page goes to region A, but as we have the path-based route, if we click on contact, we go to region B. So finally, we go to our last product, Azure Frontdoor. Like Application Gateway, Frontdoor is a layer 7 load balancer, but in a global scale. Basically, Frontdoor will have frontends around the globe, providing the closest frontend to the client, and then routing by default to the closest backend, reducing latencies. Of course, this behavior depends on the configuration, as you can also configure priorities like in Traffic Manager and other parameters to modify the routing at your will. In order to do so, Frontdoor offers a very powerful rules engine, so you can configure advanced routing rules, facilitating doing URL rewrites, path-based routing, and URL redirects, similar to what Application Gateway provides. It also has in common with Application Gateway that we have a web application firewall solution if we want to enable it. Additionally, it offers some caching features. So let's go ahead with a demo here where we will have two VMs in two different regions, and they will access their closest backend in those regions. Let me show you first the configuration for this demo. So what we will basically have is, if we go to Frontdoor Designer, we will see we have two frontend domains, okay, which are the URLs that we will use to access our sites. Then, if we go to the backend pools, we will have the two different app services on the region, and the routing rules, it will be the role that connects the frontend and the backend. So as you can see in the backend pool, we have two different app services, one in region A, the other in region B, and they have the same priorities and weights. So this means that the client will go to the closest backend based on the latency, okay? So in this case, we can change things like the backend host header that we want to send to the app service, but they don't really matter for this demo. If we go to the routing rules, we select the protocols that we want to accept, and we select the domains that we want to associate with this specific role. And then we decide what to do with the traffic. Do we forward it to the backend? Do we redirect somewhere else? Do we do URL rewrites or cache? If we wanted something else, like more advanced, we can generate our own rules, okay? So if we go to the rule engine configuration, we can add a condition. For instance, let's say that you want to read a specific custom header, and based on the value, you will take a different action. Let's say, do a URL rewrite, or do a different redirection, or, you know, you can do several actions on here, which gets actually quite advanced. So let's get into the actual demo, where we have one VM in the region A. Therefore, it will access the app service on the region A. And we have another VM in the region B, which will access the region B backend. Okay. So remember, we have two backends, region A and region B. And now we go to the region A virtual machine. If we try to access the URL of Frontdoor, it should redirect you, well, it should forward the traffic to the specific region A app service. Here we go. You see, it is in region A. Now, if we go to the other virtual machine, which is in region B, it should go to the closest backend as well, which will be in region B. We put the URL of the Frontdoor and we end on the backend of region B. So, as you have seen, there are several networking features that can help improving our experience with app services. While some products have some similarities, it is important to keep in mind the differences between them so we take the right decision for our environments. Hope this video helps in taking that decision and clarifies more the features of each product. Thanks for watching!